Alright, so let me introduce you to Camp California, because nobody else fucking will. Seriously, I hate my job sometimes. Oh my fucking god. Probably the most embarrassing thing to come out of California ever. Yes, that includes Arnold Schwarzenegger. And check out this exciting opening cinema. Damn animation. Move your lips. Oh no, don't take away that cheesy 2D artwork.
Oh no! I have to save my friends or there won't be a concert and the beach will be nuked. But I can't go anywhere without tires. I'll have to get them back first.
Whoa, dude, you better get those tires back. They're more important than your stupid friends. And as you can see, the game is an action platformer. Yeah, you got 5 different characters you can use. Some suck. Some you actually need to complete certain stages. You see, not only do you have to find stupid tires in this game, but you also have to get your musical instruments, your friends, and you have to deal with bullshit like that. One of those stupid roller coaster carts hit me out of nowhere. The controls are not too bad. You can jump, attack and all that shit. It's just staying on some of these platforms sometimes that can throw you off. Seriously, I'm jumping on fucking Legos here. I hate how tiny these platforms are. Yep, a giant saw blade, you can't touch those. It takes away 20% of your health. Amazingly enough, so do the logs. Okay, it's not even moving that fast, so, eh. Game logic, what can you do? Come on, it even looks like a platform. I won't jump on it. Now, at least there's some variety in the stages. Now here's an example where the game can shine a little bit. We have a nice little parody of Star Wars. I hope you have a lot of lives at this point because you're going to be attacked by a ton of shit. Cannonballs, piranhas, pirates that can somehow breathe underwater. Attacking you, but to attack you have to do that stupid dive.
Yeah.
Alright, so we finally got this character now. He may look like a complete dork, but even though he's one of the final characters you get in the game, he's also one of the best. Look at this, he has a projectile attack, and he can even do a little bit of flying. This character would have been so cool to have in the early stages of the game, but no. It's like playing the Sonic the Hedgehog game, but you have to play as Amy Rose first. Shit is getting real now because we're in the war stage. Yeah, we got missiles firing, barbed wire, scorpions for some reason. It's actually kind of cool, but you do take a lot of cheap hits. Okay, so here's one of the bosses. And guess what his big special attack is? Move in left and right. Man, how inventive. Imagine at the end of Final Fantasy when you fight Sephiroth. Yeah, he just moves left and right. Instead of finding a giant meteor that destroys the entire solar system. No, he just moves left and right. Yeah, kind of gruesome actually. Holy crap. They're ripping its skin off. Cool death and all, but I also remind you that this is a kid's game. And I just violently killed that scorpion. Which was probably an endangered species since it was 20 feet tall. Alright, let's just go to the end level and see what the boss is. Okay, I'm to the far right here. Okay, what the hell do I do? You'll be seeing that a lot during this game. What the hell do I do next? Alright, so here's what you're supposed to do in this stage. And of course, it's so obvious. If you jump down here, press down and button 1, you get to save this person. Alright, there's a saxophone. Let's get it and get the hell out of here. But no, you can't. You have to defeat all 3 lumberjacks in this stage, and then you can get the saxophone. Which is bullshit. It's right there. Guess what the hell you're supposed to do? Well, you're supposed to hit this door, and that's where the tire is, but if you're not careful, yeah, you can totally miss it. Simple as that. Of course, it would have been nice if the game told you, instead of having some reviewer on the internet. Hey, this Star Soldier indifferent video game goof told me, hey, this is what you're supposed to do to beat this game. Well, the game is supposed to tell you. I'm not supposed to tell you.
Let's get out of here, huh?
Yeah, let's go!
Award-winning dialogue there, folks.
What else is new?
Alright, you get Shred and I'll take care of fixing the bloody. Good luck!
Yeah, aren't our friends in danger? Why are they smiling?
That big cheese and his rats are really making me mad. I mean, they're ready to destroy my Earth without blinking an eye.
We've got to stop him before he does any more damage.
Well, let's get to it.
Oh my god, the voice acting is so terrible in this game. So unless you collect enough shit, you won't have enough gas to actually play the game. And what happens when you don't have enough gas? Your car breaks down, and you don't try to fix the car or anything. No. It takes one of your lives. You get another gas tank, and you get to drive around. Oh no, I ran out of gas. Must commit suicide. Look. If you notice, I drive from one area down to this area and took a full tank of gas. Bullshit. Yeah, driving in this game is a fucking nightmare. Thankfully, you get one whole continue. Yes, one whole continue in this game. So what the hell happened? I ran out of gas and died.
I can't believe it.
So yes, kids, if you go out driving in your vehicles and you're low on gas, just collect a whole bunch of trash on the road. You can recycle that into gasoline. And if you don't have enough gasoline, kill yourself. At least that's what the game is telling you. So in this level, you really have to tiptoe around. Move very slowly or these fights are gonna pop out of nowhere and surprise you.
Okay.
See, it's not like Ninja Spear where you actually see the guy underneath the panel actually try to attack you. No. This game is not that clever. The game is sure generous on the 1-ups though. So it's not impossible by any means. You just have to play it smart. And yes, it can be beaten. Oh god damn, is this ever a boring review? Let me go get a drink, but first let me pause the game. Especially here. Shit. Every time you go to pause the game, it does a stupid black and white shit. And then it flickers for a few seconds. Stupid fucking pause screen. Seriously, I just want to get a fucking drink. You know, games like Battletoads, you get some stupid jingle. Or, I don't know, Tetris, it says pause, so you don't see any of the action. Here we almost get a seizure-inducing screen. Look at that background, it looks so fucking flat. At least some of the music in this game is pretty good. Better be careful putting this on YouTube and all. They're gonna flay the shit out of this. Blip, no problem. We have some licensed music in here, it sounds great. But YouTube's gonna say,
you can't do that.
It's strange, why does the music suck here? It's usually been pretty good up to this point. Camp California, very average graphics, very little to no parallax scrolling in the game whatsoever. This game would have looked great in 1993. Hell, I don't even think it looked that good for 1991 actually. This is on a Turbo CD, the system has built-in memory to it. Hell, why not have a save feature? These are not short stages. Hey, you even got a score system up here. Why not save that shit? Give me some replay value. Oh no. If you want to play Camp California here, you better have a few hours free. So why do any important shit like go to your job or read to your kids when you can play some Camp California? A mediocre platformer that does everything okay, but not great. Camp California for the Turbo Duo. It earns a 52 out of 100. Okay, I won't fucking lie. I know it's more funny being critical and all, but this is a hell of a lot better than Yokuro. You must be this tall. Now, that's kind of a funny joke. I like it when games are assholes, kids. Like, there's a reason why you haven't heard of it. It's pretty generic, saccharine, and all that shit. But, hey, if you stick with it, the game is playable at least. Shut up. fucking years.